So it's very important to attend continuous classes. In case you don't attend continuous classes, then there will be some trouble. Okay, at least for the people who are in continuous, in the sense who are working for 2022 gate. Okay, for 2023 it does not matter. But keep in mind that when you go till the end, that time that particular mindset is important. It's not just about knowledge; it's about mindset also. Okay. See, I may have a lot of knowledge. I may have written, gate so many times. But still, if I don't go with the right mindset, I can fail. Not you. I can fail. Okay. So where is your station then? Okay. Not there. Okay. So we have to put the efforts. That continuous efforts matters. Okay. Fine. So now, first of all, we have seen, we were seeing about the kinetic theory of gases and statistical thermodynamics together. We were seeing how to get CP, CV and all those things, right? So we were saying, specific heats from kinetic theory of gases. This was what we are seeing, kinetic theory of gases and statistical thermodynamics. So we saw from statistical thermodynamics that internal energy is actually equal to F by 2 into R into T. Correct. This we have done. What is CV? CV is dou U by dou t at constant v. So this becomes F by 2 into R, correct? Not R like this, R. Okay, then we saw CP is equal to CV plus R, correct? So that is equal to F by 2 R plus R. So that is equal to F plus 2 divided by 2 into R. That was the CP, correct? And my gamma, which is ratio of specific heat, was CP by CV, which comes out as F plus 2 by F. Make sense? Easy? I think those people, our other friends, they are in some trouble. Tilak Raj, link is there in the... Why don't you see Apex Classroom, Mr.? Oh, he deleted now. Okay, fine. Tilak Raj, got the thing? Got the link? Are you there here? Yes. Very good, very good, very good, very good. Okay. I know, because he has a hectic day. Morning, he has to go work and come. And that time, sometimes our mind does not work. I can understand that. Okay. Okay. That's how it is. Okay. So now first we went with monoatomic gas, correct? We went with monoatomic gas. In a monoatomic gas, what is happening? There is, in terms of 6 degrees of freedom, there are just 6 degrees of freedom, out of which 3 degrees of freedom is rotation and 3 translation. This degree of rotation due to degrees of freedom due to rotation, energies are very small. Energy involved is tiny compared with degrees of freedom of translation. And therefore, F is equal to 3. So if I put that, I'll get CV is equal to 3 by 2 R, CP is equal to 5 by 2 R, and gamma is equal to 5 by 3. This we have derived the day before yesterday, students. And then we saw for helium, what is R? what is gamma, everything we saw for helium, right? Let us continue this for diatomic gas. This was a recap, okay? This was a recap, okay? So I hope there is no trouble here, students. Everything is clear? Correct? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Okay. Next. Let us go for a diatomic gas. Now, when you consider diatomic gas, you can consider just like a dumbbell. You have dumbbell here, okay? Now, this dumbbell, okay, or with the springs also here, it can have. It's not just a dumbbell, dumbbell with a spring, you can see. It's a dumbbell with a spring, okay? This is how you can think about a diatomic gas, okay? So, you can consider analogy. Analogy is dumbbell with the springs. Now, it depends on the temperature, the types of the degrees of freedom. The degrees of freedom can be 3 translation, 3 rotations, and then 2 vibration. The extra thing that comes with the diatomic gas. What is this vibration degrees of freedom? This degrees of freedom comes because if you consider this as a spring and a mass system, okay, everything goes relative to one. So one thing we can consider it as stationary, other move, is it not? Or we can take this as stationary and this moving relative to that. Now, if I consider vibrations to define the exact position of the vibrating element, how many variables we need? We need 2 variables, right? What are the 2 variables? 2 variables are position and velocity. Correct? You need position and velocity. For example, if I say a pendulum, now this is moving from here to here, okay? Now if I just say the position somewhere here, if I say the position, is it enough to predict the motion next? No, you have to say which side the velocity is, which is this side or this side. So you have to say the position as well as the velocity to specify properly the motion of this dumbbell. You need 2 additional additional variables. One is position, one is velocity. Correct? Similarly, in vibrations also, you need 2 degrees of freedom to specify the position of any oscillating body. Correct? Which is position and velocity. So that is why F is equal to 2. But now all the degrees of freedom is not excited at all temperature. At low temperatures, let me put it here, at low temperatures, I'll put it in the next slide. Please write this down, students, okay? So in a diatomic gas, these are the degrees of freedom which can be there. And for vibration, like this only, don't worry. Don't have to write in terms of notes because you're not going to write essays in GATE, is it not? It's about understanding. Understanding best happens by having a graphical notes. Correct? Don't keep on reading and putting, you're not in a English class. You are in engineering class. And engineering is very, very easy compared to English. Believe me, I have felt it firsthand. Agree, students? I don't know how many of you agree, but for me, that is a reality.
I lost connection after two vibrations. Could you just relax?
See what happens to specify a position of a vibrating body. You need to say predict the motion of a vibrating body. You need two variables. One is position and one is velocity. Because if you consider this pendulum here, which is moving from this position to this position, if say I have a pendulum at this intermediate position over here, which direction it goes? Just remembering the position is not enough. Just knowing the position is not enough. You need to know its velocity also. Correct? Make sense?
Yes, sir.
Correct. Putting its velocity, only then you can predict the next point of that. So whenever there is a vibrations which is caused like a dumbbell with a spring, as we have said diatomic gas is, correct, you need two more variables or two more degrees of freedom to specify the motion or specify the energy.
Like because define the motion.
Huh?
Like to define the motion, like to define its motion, right?
Exactly. Or define its energy for that matter.
Okay.
For example, when it is over here, observe. Potential energy is the maximum, right? When it is here, kinetic energy is the maximum, correct? Make sense?
Yes, sir.
So that conversions, when it is happening, you need to know what is the kinetic energy. If you want to know, you need to know the velocity properly, is it not? Not just, yeah. Position, potential energy can be told with respect to position, no problem. But kinetic energy also required to say what is the next way it will go, is it not? Basically, we have to write, okay, we will not complicate the things, okay. I'm bringing chaotic advection here. Okay, I'm sorry. I was trying to, but I did not. Just resisted. It would have simply complicated the issues. Not required. Keep it simple and sweet. Yes.
Done, sir.
Keep it simple and sweet. Yes. Done. Now let us see. Now what happens at low temperature? At low temperatures, in a diatomic gas, only degrees of freedom associated with the translation has noticeable energy, noticeable energy. Therefore, at low temperatures, for a diatomic gas, okay, F is equal to 3. So similar to, we have the Cv is 3 by 2 R, Cp is 5 by 2 R, and gamma is equal to 5 by 3. Done. Now let us go next one at intermediate temperature. At intermediate temperature, okay, along with translation, two additional modes of degrees of freedom or addition motion or modes of degrees of freedom is excited. Which is rotation along the axis perpendicular to the line connecting the two atoms along the line joining rotation along the line rotation rotational energy along the line connecting the atoms is negligible since the size of atoms is small compared with the distance between them. Correct. Atoms are just like, if you consider atoms, the nucleus is here. It's like sun, and the electrons are like these planets. You know how far the sun and the planets are, is it not? Somebody was saying that if you have, say, distance is very big. I'll not say the thing. You can see some of the videos where you can actually, when you consider a solar system, what is done in your labs, or if you see in schools, okay, that's a very wrong model of solar system. The real model of a solar system is some, if you have a, what do you say, if you have a sun, okay, and if you say this is about a football size, okay, football size sun, okay, then the earth is at a distance of, say, a football field, you know, the football field, if you say football field, okay, if you say football field, okay, at a distance of the other end of the football field, it is like a speck, okay, that's how the distances are. Okay. So when it is rotating along the axis like this, okay, when it is rotating along this axis, you see how less the energy is. That is why only two energy is two rotation, that is rotation along these two axes, rotation here and rotation here. These are excited, but this one is energy. Even though it's excited, the energy is very small, negligible. So we don't consider that. Make sense? Now put it into CP, CV and all those things. So what is the degrees of freedom here? Therefore, at intermediate temperature, F is equal to 3 plus 2, which is equal to 5. Apply that back into the CP, CV and gamma equation and find out what is CV, CP and gamma. Diatomic, monoatomic tarane behave agudu. So you say air at around say minus 150 degree centigrade or 200 minus 200 degree centigrade. No, minus 200 degree centigrade, nitrogen liquefies, is it? No? Or even nitrogen, if you consider, which is a diatomic gas, and it goes to low temperature. But low temperature, we can reduce the pressure and keep it in a gaseous state, is it not? We can always do that.
Yes, sir.
So you don't have to say liquefying temperature is on atmospheric temperature, atmospheric pressure, is it not? So when you go lower temperature, the lower pressure, you can have it at even lower temperatures, you can have it in gaseous mode. Done, students? Have you written it down? Pratik ji is there? No. Okay, not there. Fine. Pratik, you are there? No. No, Pratik is not there. Okay, fine. Devaraj Mulya has some connection troubles. Have you written this down, students?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Next. Now, if I consider here, what is the CP? Or CV. CV is F by 2, which is equal to 5 by 2 into R. This is CV. What is CP? CP is 7 by 2 into R. What is gamma? Gamma is 7 by 5. What is 7 by 5? It is 1.4. Example for this is our air only. Okay. What is CV for air? CV for air. What is R for air? R for air is around 8314 divided by 287. Sorry, 287 is the R, and so 29, which comes nearly about 287. So if I consider 287 is the R, kilojoules per kg Kelvin, 287 joules per kg Kelvin is the R characteristic gas constant, or for what? For our air. Correct, for air. So what is CV? CV is 5 by 2 into 287. What does that come to? You can see that it comes down to, this is the something which you have to remember, students. Okay, 5 into 287 divided by 2, it comes to 17.5, correct? Yes. Newton per, sorry, what Newton? Joules per kg Kelvin, correct? What is CP? CP is 7 by 2 into 287. So what is that? 7 by 2 into 287 comes out to 7 divided by 2. It comes out to be 1004.5. This is generally taken as 718, and this is generally taken as 1005. Correct. So 1005 joules per kg Kelvin. This is also joules per kg Kelvin. What is gamma CP by CV? It is 7 by 5, which is 1.4 for air at intermediate temperature. Very important. At intermediate temperatures. Make sense, students? Hello. So that's why we take for air 1.4 is the gamma. Now, why is gamma important? We will see one by one. Next, at higher temperature, what happens? Two more additional thing will come. Okay. This is very, very important, students. So to remember this. Important, very, very, very important. Tell me when you are done writing, students. Next we will go at higher temperature. Yes, tell me.
Sir,
tell me, dear. Not able to hear. Basically, probably your internet is weak. You can message. You may message. Who is asking? Diviraj, is it not? Previous slide, okay. You can take the screenshot of this, Diviraj, okay? Because it will slow down the class, okay? Taken the screenshot? Kindly take the screenshot of this. Done. Next, you can take this screenshot. Diviraj ji.
Sir, yes, message in the chat, just check.
Okay, only she has it.
No. He has written it, he wants to finish. Just check the chat.
Okay. I need you to explain from which second line I have written it, okay? I need to explain from which second line, okay? This second line, Baba. At low temperature, F is equal to 3.
At intermediate, sir. At intermediate temperature.
Along with the translation, two additional modes of degrees.
Line.
Yes, this one. Okay. Additional modes of degrees of freedom is excited. Which is rotation along the axis, which is rotation along axis perpendicular to the line connecting the two atoms. So if the two atoms are there, there is a line connecting the two atoms, is it not? Perpendicular to that, there is two rotations which is happening. Okay. Only these are significant. The one which is along the line connecting the two axes, that is rotation in this fashion, is small because the atomic sizes are small. Make sense? So we have only two additional degrees of freedom because of rotation. Although technically we should have three. Correct. Actually, we have only two. Correct? Because the other one is insignificant. Make sense? Diviraj, make sense? Hello, Diviraj. Yes, very good. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So now, yes. Okay. So now let us go further. Okay. One second. Yes. So now, further going, further. Okay. Next point here, we will see what is at high temperatures. At high temperatures, F is equal to 3 for translation plus 2 for rotation plus 2 for vibrations. So totally you have 7 degrees of freedom. So F is equal to 7. So my CV becomes 7 by 2 into R. CP becomes 9 by 2 into R. And gamma becomes equal to 9 by 7. 9 by 7 is how much, students? We can just see. 1 point something, is it not? Obviously 1 point something. 9 divided by 7. 1.28. This is almost equal to 1.2857. Correct? That is the gamma you may get. Okay. Now the question see, now this is actually oversimplified. This is much oversimplified, but can act as a thumb rule for initial. Or it generally engineering, all the engineering application, this is enough. Okay. So if you see, this is, say, this is CV, and then we have R. So this is R, this is 2R, 2R is somewhere here, 2R, then we may have 3R, correct? So 3R, 7 by 2 is 3.5R, you see. This is almost 2.5R, correct? So now, this is because of translation. This is because of rotation. And this is because of vibration. And the x-axis is temperature axis. X-axis is the temperature axis. This is CV axis, okay?
Sir, the rotation between the two atoms will be same at high temperature also, like it will be negligible at high temperature.
Yes,
also.
Because it is of, because of the geometry.
Okay, fine.
It's because of the geometry, correct? Compared to the atomic size, the difference here is like this. This much difference is there. I'm saying still, I may be wrong in predicting the this one, okay? This might not be actual, this one, actual, because nucleus is very small here. The distance between the nucleus and the outer, you can say, shells, which are there, is huge, just like our sun and the planets. It's similar distances. There is something called fractals in chaos. Fractals, okay, which says that whenever you zoom to any level, the same things are repeated. Okay, the same thing happens here also. I'll show you one exciting one. Okay, if you consider, I'll just show you this. Where is YouTube? Okay, so if I consider Mandelbrot. Set zoom. Let us understand this. Okay. So this is a lot of times it comes fractal zoom. Observe here. This is Mandelbrot set. Okay, Mandelbrot set. See now. This is coming from basic equations only. Okay, this happens repeated. It is zooming up. It is zooming up everywhere. Observe. And then it zooms somewhere else. Again, the same thing is repeated. Observe. After some time, the same thing gets repeated. This comes from basic equations only. It's not something difficult. This is how nature happens. In 1970s, Mandelbrot said that. And the equations are really, really simple here, students. Okay. Similar thing happens in nature also. Okay. So you see here, he puts a lot of places where you can do it. This is one of the basic things about nature. Okay. Anyhow, so I explained you that to say that these things are actually in nature also. Whatever is in the higher one is there on the lower side also. It's repeated again and again. Planets, then our atoms. We have not gone beyond that, is it not? I don't know whether we'll be reaching there or not. The world is, the nature, the reality is very, very, very complex. We small humans don't know how much is there, is it not? Yes. Done, students? Clear? Tell me when you're finished writing. Then we will go. How do we get adiabatic in the sense adiabatic process. Okay, how to get adiabatic process, we will see. Something more about adiabatic. PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. Why does PV raised to gamma is equal to constant in adiabatic process? Done, students?
Sir, generally for what all gases we need to know the molecular weight?
For gate?
Yes, sir.
For gate, you put helium, hydrogen, helium, maybe carbon. Okay. Carbon, why we are taking carbon? Because we take carbon dioxide, is it not? That is the reason. Okay. But carbon dioxide you can take. Then what is required for engineering? Okay. Helium, hydrogen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, oxygen. Enough. Nitrogen, oxygen. Then what else are there? This is more than enough, students. These are more than enough. Other things are not required. Okay. This is more than enough. Okay. More. And most of the time they will give you in the gate exam. They will not test your knowledge. They will test only your understanding. Okay. But these five you need to know. Okay. You cannot compromise on this. Done? Hello.
Hello.
Huh?
Okay.
No, I'm not hearing you.
Is the graph of
this is a graph of CV, that is specific heat at constant volume and temperature. Okay, when the temperature is less, only translation mode is activated. So what is it? The CV is actually 3/2 R. When it becomes more, say when CV becomes when the higher temperature is reached, intermediate temperature is reached, CV becomes 5/2 R, that is 2.5 R. So it's here. Still higher temperature, vibration is excited and becomes 7/2, 3.5. That's what is specified here. That's it. Make sense? Yeah, tell me, Divyaraj.
Yes, sir.
Yes, very good. Thank you. Where are others? Where is our... there are a lot of people who have missed classes today. Okay, maybe because they have internals or something like that. all the NITTE students are not there. Whether it is our Sharan is there. Sharan, you have internals or something like that?
No, sir.
No, right. Okay. So our yeah, it's okay. Shishir Vallal is not there. Anyhow, who is the other person? Okay. Anyhow, a lot of people who are not there. Okay. So control P. Okay. Now let us go further. Now let us take adiabatic process. Adiabatic process of an ideal gas. With constant specific heats. Specific heats, HEATS. Because two specific heats are there, correct? So let us see how we can do that, okay? Now, from first law. We know that we can write delta Q, that is heat, is equal to du plus delta W. Is it not, students? So now, if I say in an adiabatic process, what happens? What is an adiabatic process? Adiabatic process is the one where there is no exchange of heat. Okay, in an adiabatic process, heat transfer is not present. This implies delta Q is equal to zero. So what we will get? Zero is equal to du plus delta W. Or I can say, what is delta W in an adiabatic process? Okay, we will consider closed system. Okay, so in a closed system, delta W, it is closed system only we have to take, because whenever you say closed system, it is control mass and all the laws of physics are for control mass. So we have to take closed system, and only in the steady flow energy equation, we put it to open system. Don't ask, sir, why are you taking only closed system? Because laws of physics are only for closed system, correct? So we can say delta W is equal to P into dV, correct? PdV is the delta W, correct? PdV, fine. So now we will put it here. So zero is equal to du plus delta W. Instead of delta W, we will put PdV. Fine. Now, what is du? Du is CV dT. Fine. What is, instead of PdV, okay, I can put directly, okay, instead of PdV, I can put this as, just a second, students. Okay. DT here, fine. Okay. Plus PdV. Okay. This way I can write. Another point here, let us understand. If I consider ideal gas. For an ideal gas, PV is equal to RT. Correct. Or I can say, instead of this, I can say T is equal to PV by R. Or I can say DT is equal to 1 by R. DT is equal to 1 by R into PdV plus VdP. Can I say it like that? So let us substitute this DT, substituting 1, I get 0 is equal to 1 by R into CV, or CV by R, R is coming from here, and then PdV plus VdP plus PdV. Makes sense, students? Or I will go further and I can write 0 is equal to Here PDV, VDP, all those things are available. Okay. So we can we'll rearrange in the next slide. Okay. Write this down till here, students. Write this down till here. Till here is clear? No doubts, it's just algebra here. Aitan Makle, is it over, students?
Sir.
Yes, please tell me, no. Don't worry about if a person does not finish it, he will tell, I have not finished. Okay. So once you finish, you tell me. Okay. Now, what we can have, we have got that 0 is equal to CV by R into PDV plus VDP plus PDV. Correct. This is what we have got last this one. So we can write CV by R into PDV plus PDV plus CV by R into VDP. This is coming here. This is coming here. Okay. Or I can say 1 plus CV by R, 1 plus CV by R into PDV, or we will do one thing, okay? We will divide the whole thing by CV by R, okay? Let us divide by CV by R. Dividing by CV by R, we will get 0 is equal to PDV plus R by CV into PDV plus VDP. I can write this as 0 is equal to VDP plus 1 plus R by CV into PDV. Make sense? Okay. Now, I can further say what is this? This can be written as 0 is equal to VDP plus CV plus R by CV. What is that, student? CV plus R is what? CV plus R is CP, is it not? So this comes as equal to 0 is equal to VDP plus CP by CV, which is actually gamma into DV, correct? So I can write, when I continue this, I can write it as VDP plus gamma into PDV is equal to 0. Make sense? VDP plus gamma into PDV is equal to 0, correct? Or I can write this as divided by PV. If you divide by PV, I can write dP by P plus gamma into dV by V is equal to 0. Now, when you solve this equation, you will see that this is nothing but comes with PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. When you integrate this, you will get this. For example, if you differentiate, what you will get? You will get, first of all, this is constant you take first of all. Okay, when you do the differentiation, what you can have? You can write dP by, in this one. Okay, we can write it as V raised to gamma into dP plus we have this again. When you differentiate, you get gamma into P into V raised to gamma minus 1, correct? When you differentiate, you get V raised to gamma minus 1 dV, correct students? That is equal to 0. Now what you do, divide by V raised to gamma into P. What you will get? Dividing by V raised to gamma into P, you will get the same thing. Divide by V raised to gamma into P. So when you do that, you get dP by P plus we have here you have when you divide by V raised to gamma, what remains? Here gamma into dV by V remains is equal to 0. So this integration is this only, correct? Make sense? So this is how you get that in an adiabatic process, PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. Make sense?
Yes, sir.
Very easy. This is the source we have to find, okay? Now, still further, we will see some more things about. See, first of all, we will do all the basic one and then we will go for problems. Okay, we will do a lot of problems. Problem seems easy now. Problem seems very, very easy now. One of the things you have to do is these concepts you have to again and again go through these concepts. That time you will see how easy the problems will become. Okay, recap this again and again. And especially before the class, you know, one habit you do, students, that before 10 to 15 minutes of a class, just flip the pages, what has happened in the previous classes. Just flip it. That's enough. Don't have to do it a lot. Okay, just see. Just like a supervisor sees subordinates. See whether they are hearing to you or not. Whether they are in your control or not. Okay. Like that, you do before every class and you will see how much difference will it come. Before every class, 15 minutes, enough.
Sir, can you explain from that, divide by PV after that step?
Yes. See, when you divide by PV, this, if you divide by PV, what happens? PV you divide, V cancels, P remains. Here, PV you divide, P cancels, V remains, correct?
Yes, sir.
Now this I say can be written as PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. That means when you differentiate, you have to get this, is it not?
Yes, sir.
So let us differentiate. When you differentiate, what you get? V raised to gamma dP plus gamma into P raised to gamma into P into V raised to gamma minus 1 dV, correct? Divide by V raised to gamma into P. Correct? When you do that, you get this same thing. It's the same.
Okay.
That's how it is. This we have done in first order differential equations. You remember that, students? Xy raised to n is equal to constant. Or even separation of variables also you can do this, correct? Just integrate that, you get P here. You can write log p here. When you integrate, you get log p. Here you get gamma into log v. Okay, you take a exponent of this, you will get this only. Okay, you can directly integrate and see, you will get this also. Okay. Dv by dp by p is log p, correct? Gamma into dv by v, dv by v is log v, gamma goes up, correct? Goes as exponent, makes sense? Basic differential equations. So we'll stop here, students. Afterwards, we will see the relationship between pressure, temperatures in a adiabatic process. Then next, we will go to some other concepts, okay? Which is very, very important today, what I'm doing, okay? Thank you very much, students. Thank you very much.
Sir, could you go to like two slides, prior two slides?
This one?
Before this.
This one?
Yes, sir. This one. Sir, what we did here actually?
We just for air, what is the R? R is 287. We just substituted this.
That much only.
That much only, nothing great. Because this is familiar to us, we use it a lot of times, is it not?
Yes, sir.
That's the reason we did this. Makes sense. Nitin, are you learning something new, or whatever you knew, you are learning again?
Revising something.
Yeah?
Revising the old things.
You knew these things, right? Beforehand?
Some I knew, sir. Some I like that. Degrees of freedom and all, I didn't know.
Decrease of
freedom. You told today, no, sir. Vibrational degrees of freedom.
Degrees of freedom. Degrees of freedom. Yes. This one will be done generally. Okay, this part, the last part. This part will be generally done. Okay, our the Prashant Kamath sir would have also done. Is it not, Ramakrishna?
Yes, sir.
He's very good. In Kendra Engineering College, there is a professor called Prashant Kamath. He is very, very good in these thermodynamics. Anyhow, chalo students.
Sir.
Ha.
In that first slide that you started with the diatomic gas, for that translation is 3 degrees of freedom, vibration is 2, and rotation is 3 or 2, sir?
Rotation is 2. Rotation is 2 because 1 degree of freedom is negligible. See this one. Read it again.
Okay, that because of the distance.
Exactly.
I think you have written 3, sir. Go back to that main slide.
This one?
Yes, sir.
In general.
Okay, in general it is there, but considering, we are considering only 2. Okay, yes. Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you.
Sir, could you go to that slide only? Yes, sir. That last 3 lines, could you explain it?
This one, F is equal to 3 plus 2 is equal to 5.
The rotational energy along
the line connecting the atoms is negligible. Why? Since the size of the atom is small compared with the distance between them. Size of the atom is small. So what happens? The rotational energy becomes very small, is it not? What is rotational energy? Rotational energy is related to I and omega, right? I omega square, right? I itself is very small.
Yeah,
correct.
Sir, in this PV, if PV bar gamma to, is equal to constant, that is always specific volume only.
Which one?
This V. It is always specific volume in the
specific
final.
Volume. Here it is specific volume, yes. When you say PV is equal to RT, here we are taking specific volume.
So, specific volume. Otherwise, it will become PV equal to MRT. Okay.
Yes, yes. Otherwise, it will become PV is equal to MRT. Correct.
Like, we just bring M this side to like V by M becomes specific. Okay, okay.
Exactly. Good.